Hello everybody. Welcome, it's Captain Kevin. And this is Austrian Adventures, flight number 3. Today we go from Salzburg to Werfen and the Konigsee, and then to the Kehlsteinhaus, Berchtesgaden, back to Salzburg. Here's the route. Flying an Icon A5 on Microsoft Simulator 2020. Let's see how we get on. We're here at the Salzburg Airport. Runway 15, straight ahead of us is the Untersburg. Let's get the power going up. And away we go. Max thrust. Flaps are down. Keep it straight. Keep it really straight. Straight out departure today, mostly a southerly direction. Going through 40 knots. 60, we can fly. Nose up. Nose up. Here we go. And airborne. Airborne from the Salzburg W.A. Mozart Airport. Gear up. Flaps up. Beautiful day to go flying. Puffy white clouds. As we go south, let's just do a quickie little view over the city of Salzburg. Can't help myself. Nice view behind. We're going to go over to pick up the Salzach River as we go south. It's a good, pretty well right along our whole route. At least half of the route. Straight ahead of the aircraft on the hill stuck up ahead is the Hohensalzburg, the Festung Hohensalzburg, or Fortress Hohensalzburg Castle. Videos, flights number 1 and 2 had good looks at this castle, so if you want a nice longer view of it, go back to video number 1 or 2. This is just going to be a flyby. Leveling it off at about 1900 feet. And here comes your view of one of the finest medieval castles in all of Europe, the Festung on Salzburg. Here comes the Salzach River. We're going to make that right turn and follow the river now. And I've speeded up the video. We're doing 4x, four times the video. But still get a good view. Allows us to cover some distance at, oh, roughly 400 miles an hour instead of 100 miles an hour. And as I mentioned, the Salzach. Heading due south, south of Salzburg, towards the mountains. On the right wing, that's the Untersberg. A nice sightseeing trip with some very special views. Very special places we're going to visit on this trip. Coming up ahead is the city of Hallein. Hallein, of course, is the salt mine nearest to Salzburg. And the Dürrenberg and the Celtic Museum. Again, see those on flight number 1. We'll just do a flyby because we're headed south. We're headed south towards Werfen. Again, continuing along the Salzach. And picking up highway at the upper route A10. Here we go. It pretty well parallels the river all the way south as far as you want to go with it. It'll take you to Italy, actually. Looks like up ahead it's running right into the mountains. Matter of fact, if you look carefully, you'll see a tunnel. A tunnel! Can we do it? I don't think so. No, we're not going in a tunnel. We're going to bail out to the left here and find the pass through this hilly area. The pass Lue, L-U-E-G, Lue. Doing my best with German, give me a break. Here's the pot pass at 2,200 feet. You'll see the auto loop coming out on the other side here momentarily. the name of the gorge, Salzburg, and there's the river, and highway coming out the other side. Now as we continue south through that narrowest part of the valley, it'll widen out here. Big mountain on the left, we want to take a look at that. It has a unique feature up a higher level, so we're climbing up now up above 3,000 feet. Maybe I have to go up to about 4, I think. And as we get close to this mountain now, found only in the last few hundred years was this ice horizon belt, a beautiful ice cave, really worth visiting. Coming down now from the mountain, just a few miles to the south, and look at what we have up ahead, the Festung Hohenwerfen. Maybe you remember the movie Where Eagles Dare, Clint Eastwood. Fantastic movie, and it was all about trying to get prisoners out of this castle, the Hohenwerfen. Richard Burton was in that movie. Oh, so many famous movie stars. Mostly filmed during the winter, but this is the computer-generated image of the Hohenwerfen. Remember, this is a flight simulator, and there's a high-resolution picture of what the Hohenwerfen really looks like. Town of Werfen, not too far away, of course, and now something very, very special. Not far from the village city of Werfen is this meadow, this mountain pasture. I'm all set up for a landing, gears down, flaps are down. Privately owned land, straight ahead now. But in 1960s, early 60s, famous movie was filmed here. Back. Very steep landing. Yeah, the sound of music, meadow. We made it! Whoa, it's steep. Okay. Julie, do your thing. So yes, that's the actual meadow where the hills of Alive opening scene of The Sound of Music was filmed. Let's see if we can safely exit this very, very steep landing site. Here we go. Whoa. Max thrust. Get some flaps. And away we go. Keep it straight. Whoa, little right. Oh no. Yeah. Ah. Coming up. Coming up. Man. Airborne. Yes, we made it. Ha ha. Gear up. Flaps going up. Wow, there's Werfen behind us. Now we're looking for the valley. Okay. Looking for that beautiful wide valley. See that mountain off the right, wingtip way in the distance, the whole Konig, the highest King Mountain area. So go up this narrow valley. Let's just double check. Yeah, we're in the middle of the valley, and it's going up there towards, okay, we're going up towards Konigsee. So we've got exactly the right valley. This little airplane should be able to make it up to about 10,000 feet. I know I need about, 8,500 feet or so. On the left is the Hochkonig, and just below us now is a Schloss Blumbach. Castle built in the middle of this valley. Look at this Fox Canyon that I'm trying to climb up to. 6,000 feet now. Will we make it without turning around and climbing? I think so. Maybe. Go, little airplane, go. You can do it. Because on the other side of this mountain, my maps tell me there's the most beautiful fjord lake you could find. Oh, I almost got it. 7,000 feet. I'm going to need all of that. 7,002 below the Von Hill. We go. Ah, we made it. 7,400 feet, and the Obersee. We're headed downhill now. And look at this other fantastic lake. Here's the Konigsee. And first, right at the Narrows, there's an old church. Let's take a look. I think we can land right by that church. So here we are coming in for a landing on the Konigsee. And we're at the Kirche St. Bartholomew. Beautiful old church. That's where the seaplane comes in handy. You see an old church, you pop in, take a look at it. Okay. Told you that'd be a special lake. All right, let's continue our exploration to the south. Yeah, sorry. We're in the south, but here to Salzburg. We'll head north now on the Konigsee. Max thrust. There's the St. Bartholomew Church on the left. And airborne. And of course that church was a pilgrimage church, being so far away from cities and towns, it became a pilgrimage church. And as we go down in the northernmost part of the lake, I'm looking at another landing. Let's check this out, right between the island and touching down. Just a beam, the Kreisliga Island. And power off. Let's land it. And here's the village called Konigsee. And slow it down. Power's off. Turn it around. That's how Microsoft Flight Simulator images the city. It's a much prettier city than that, I hope, when we visit it one day. Here we have our flaps down again. Thrust coming up. Let's get out of here. Away we go. Keep it straight. I gotta go between the island and the mainland. Little left here. Got my speed. 40 knots. Almost enough. 50. That should do it. Nose up. Pull away. Come on, little airplane, you can go. Yeah, good. Up we go. Wow. Flaps are up. Find a little wider spot in the lake to turn, and around we go. Speed's good. Should be able to easily get turned around here. Here's the view. And we're heading north. There's the village on the right, Konigsee, and we continue our trip northbound. Next stop, the direction of Berchtesgaden. And here's Berchtesgaden. The mountains nearby have a very special building. Built in World War II as a gift. Das Kehlsteinhaus. There's a nice high-res picture of it. Or the Eagle's Nest. Not to be confused with the one over in Werfen, which was a movie called the Eagle's Nest. This is the real deal, the Eagle's Nest. Now, as we leave the Berchtesgaden area, we're heading north, much the same way we came before, village of Unterau, town of Mark Schellenberg. You see some wide flat land up ahead. That's going to be the Salzburg area. First on the left, the Untersburg. Can't miss that if you're in Salzburg. It's ever present. And it tells me that we're close to home. Off to the left, long strip out there to the left is the Salzburg Airport, runway 33, and we're headed for that. Down through 5,000 feet and descending over the city of Salzburg. Straight ahead of us is the fortress Hohensalzburg. Lined up, classic approach and landing, looking for the red and white on the left, the precision approach indicator, runway markings, and touch it down, keep it straight, that's it, we got it, another successful flight. Let's see if we can get a parking spot. There you go, ladies and gentlemen, a nice tourist view of the area due south of Salzburg, with the highlights being the ice region involved, the Hohenwerfen, across the mountain range to the Konigsee, don't forget the Sound of Music meadow, the hills were alive, Berchtesgaden and the Eagle's Nest, and home through the mountains to Salzburg. And Austrian Adventures, flight number 3 now complete. Join us for flight 4 if you can, down to Zell-Am-Zee, Kitzbühel and Kufstein. Kitzbühel and Hahnenkamm and Kufstein. Thank you for watching.